Did you know that you could be damaging your probe if you input too high of a voltage and frequency, even if it's within the specified range of the probe? An important guideline that engineers often forget to think about is the derating curve. Hi, I'm Melissa. In this episode of Probing Pitfalls, you'll learn what a derating curve of a passive probe is and how following it can prevent damage and extend the life of your probe. This is important because as your probe becomes damaged, your measurements become less accurate. So what does derating even mean? The derating curve is a guideline showing how best to use a probe. Using a probe at its maximum bandwidth and maximum voltage specification at the same time can damage the probe. So we derate the probe specifications to show optimal use cases. Here's an example. The curve is simply the graphical representation of this derating guideline showing frequency versus voltage. It's best to measure signals with specs that fall under this curve. Anything above the curve can be potentially harmful to your probe and decrease its lifespan. So you may have a 300 VRMS 1 GHz probe, but that doesn't mean you can measure that large of a voltage at that fast of a frequency without damaging the probe. The derating curve is determined by the effect that the frequency has on the probe's capacitors, which means as the frequency of the signal being input into the probe increases, the capacitive reactance decreases. This allows more current to flow through the capacitor. This can be more easily understood by looking at how this curve is calculated. The calculated AC power that is dissipated across both probe's capacitors' ESRs, equivalent series resistance, the RMS current, voltage, resistance, frequency, capacitance, and dissipation factor can all be used to understand the curve. As frequency or capacitance increases, the voltage the probe can handle will decrease. This is the key relationship in creating the derating curve. At DC and low frequency, the capacitor is basically an open, so there is no current flow and therefore no risk of degrading the capacitor. That is why the plot stays constant at the beginning of the curve. As the frequency increases, the capacitor is at risk above certain voltages. If you degrade or damage your capacitor, your measurements will start to be less and less accurate. To avoid this, always check the derating curve specific to your passive probe. Following it will extend the probe's lifetime and ensure high performance. The derating curve will show you if your input and frequency are within a safe range so that you don't damage your probe. If you want to learn more about probing, click on the link. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook.